So this is where my mind is going, thinking about what people are doing all over the world, right? And again, I love the creativity. And it got me to thinking that all over the world, we are, for the first time probably in history, on the same plane, no matter where you are, from the guy in South Africa to the woman in Israel to me sitting here in my home studio in South Florida, we're all experiencing the same thing. We're shut in, we're hunkering down at home, trying to avoid spreading or picking up this virus. So spending way too much time online, right? So last night, I'm just, you know, perusing things on Facebook, looking for more funny videos. And somebody suggested adding me to a group. And the group on Facebook, and you know, I'm not the biggest Facebook fan, but it is good for killing time. And this Facebook group is called, and of course, watch, I lost it. It's called View from a Window, if I can find it. So basically, the way this group works, it's people all over the world show a picture of the view from their window. And I'm seeing posts from people from, you name it, Turkey, Denmark, Norway, South Africa, Zimbabwe, Brazil, every corner of the planet. So what I started doing was messaging some people and saying, hey, you are, for instance, here's a woman, Marta Bolett Stetcher. Marta Bolett Stetcher is in, let's see, she is in Denmark. What she wrote, and let me bring up the picture for those of you watching on YouTube, here's the photo she posted. It's a beautiful picture. You just see it looks like, I guess it's a sunrise. And she wrote, view from my window in Logten near Aarhus in Denmark. She wrote, I get up early in the morning before my two kids, aged 12 and 10, because I have to have some work done. They are out of school right now, so I'm helping them at home with their homework together with working full-time, being a single mom and self-employed, and having online courses for the moment. 113 candidate student at Aarhus University in career coaching. And right now they need it more than ever. Stay safe and stay home. Have a great weekend with the view from your window. So I messaged her along with a lot of other people and said, hey, would you be willing to talk? So let's see if this will work. I'm going to try to bring her in. I'm trying to call now. Let's see if this will work. I have no idea. Okay, so it's ringing. Ah, and there she is. Hi.
Hi.
So, Marta Bolett, am I pronouncing your name correctly?
Yeah, it's right. Yeah.
Hi.
Totally.
Thank you so much for joining us. First of all, and now I'm going to try to bring your video up. Excuse me to on the video here. I don't know if this will work or not. I have no idea. For some reason, I don't have a picture here. But oh, there you are. Hi.
Yeah.
So
hi.
There's Marta Bolett. You're in Denmark. Where in Denmark are you?
Yeah, I have my son as well.
Hi. Yeah. This is your 10-year-old son, 12-year-old son?
12-year-old son.
Hi. Yeah. It's so nice to meet you. Hi. Yeah. So we're on the air here. I'm in Florida, in South Florida, in the United States. And as I was just telling the listeners, I found you online in this wonderful Facebook group called View from the Window. And I loved your picture there in Denmark. And and I was just marveling at the fact that all over the world, we're in this shared, weird place where we're all experiencing the same thing for probably the first time in the history of the world. All over the planet, we're all in the same predicament, trying to figure out how to make it through and not get sick. So in Denmark, is it the law? Are you required to stay at home right now?
We are allowed to go out and we can be together with other people, maximum 10 people at the moment. But they have sort of a law that they could put it in action if it develops further, that only two persons can meet. But we need to have a distance, and, you know, we wash our hands all the time, and my kids and I at home, we do it as well.
So you're washing your hands a lot, and you can get together with 10 people at the same time.
But we don't do that. We don't meet with anyone. We stay at home and we don't meet with anyone. And many people, they don't like shopping. I don't like to go to the supermarket, so I buy most of my stuff online, and they put it outside the door, and they knock on my door, and then they know that I know that it's delivered at my front door. So I'm more or less stuck here. But our government, they have really, you know, done a tremendous job in order to create some great conditions for us here.
Now, Mark Tabolette, you in Denmark, first of all, Denmark is widely always at the top of the lists of the happiest places in the world. And I guess that's because you have a great government there where they actually take care of the citizens, right? You pay a little bit higher in taxes, but everything is covered, right? Your kids don't have to worry about when they're ready to go to university. That's all covered in your taxes, isn't it?
Yeah, it's covered from our taxes. And, you know, people, when they get unemployed, they get money from the government. And at the moment, the government, they have launched 13 packages, economic packages, to help all people in all different areas. For instance, I am self-employed. And I have a small company, but it's only me in that company. I coach people, and I'm having online courses for graduates at the universities in career coaching. But if I didn't have these courses, then there would be money from the government, and I could get money every week, because I am not covered in the same way as a normal worker would be.
Right. But you also, here in the States, we have a very weird healthcare system. First of all, it's a for-profit system, which makes no sense at all. But for most people, their health insurance, you need health insurance, is tied to their jobs. So most people get their insurance through their employer. Like you, I'm self-employed. This radio show is my job. And, you know, I earn money through listeners who contribute. Exactly. They support the show. I buy my insurance through a private insurance plan, believe it or not. So we have a problem now where, first of all, the tests for the coronavirus, for COVID-19, are really hard to come by. But there was a question at the beginning, what happens if you're uninsured or if you have a high copay for your insurance? Yeah. Who pays for the test? And now they said, well, we're waiving all the costs for the test if you can even find one. But then the dilemma is, if you get sick, if you get infected, who pays for the treatment? That's not a worry over there in Denmark for you, is it? What happens if you get sick?
No, not at all. The government pays everything, and it's free to go to, you know, the hospital to have a surgery, or if you get COVID-19, then you are treated and you don't have to pay anything, and people will take care of you.
Wow.
And, you know, it's just amazing. It's really amazing.
It really is. So what happens over there? I mean, do you feel that you pay too much in taxes? Does the government take too much from you? Is there anything that you're dissatisfied with over there?
No, not at all. In fact, I think some companies, they may be dissatisfied with paying a lot of taxes. But, you know, I think that we are having this social system where, for instance, every evening now from 8 to 9, there is a community song all over Denmark where it's from the Danish broadcasting company, the national broadcasting company. They are holding this community song where people from all over Denmark, they sing.
Wow.
And they sing on balconies, they sing out of windows, they have candles in their window, and you know, they are having this public spirit, you know, like community, and we are people helping each other, and they are trying to sort out how can we help the elderly people if they need anything.
Wow.
So it's really amazing.
This sounds wonderful. Wonderful. Are you ready for an influx of Americans?
Yeah, I don't know. I think that the Danish people, they want to contribute to others as well. So they are thinking about how can they help. And for instance, on my online course, I have an Italian girl. And I think she feels happy that she's in Denmark at the moment.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I'll bet. I'll bet. Yeah. So let me ask you this. I'm looking. We have a chat room going. And so a couple of questions from the chatters. Somebody asked, are your hospitals overflowing like ours are right now? Because things here are pretty crazy, especially in New York. They're overflowing. We don't have enough ventilators for the people that are coming in with the infection. How is it in Denmark? Are they holding the infected numbers down, or is it out of control there as well?
It's not out of control in any way. We have enough space for the people who have got corona or COVID-19. And in fact, we have 117 people in hospital.
That's
at the moment.
Wow.
No, 517 people.
Still, that's it.
Yeah, and that's a decrease from yesterday. 5 persons less than yesterday.
Wow.
We have 139 dead people, and they are actually from the very beginning on the 11th of March. Our Prime Minister Mette Frederiksen, she went on national television and said, we are going to help you, we are going to do this together, but you have to be strong and you have to follow what the government says that you should do. And also our Queen, she went on national television, I think a week later, telling us to stay strong and that we have to have a distance to one another and wash our hands and do all the things. So yeah.
And when you need medical care, do you have to wait a long time for an appointment or to get, say, elective surgery? Are there inordinate waiting times? Is it, you know, are there things where you need help and you need medical care that you can't get it right away?
Yeah, you can get it right away. Yeah.
Yeah. See,
And I in fact, 10 days ago, I had this appointment because I needed to look into my stomach to figure out whether something was wrong. And there was nothing wrong with me.
Uh-huh.
I was afraid if I should go to this clinic to have this done. And it's, you know, I don't pay anything for it. And they said that we take our precautions. And of course, you have your time and you just come here and we take care of you. So,
wow.
Yeah, so we don't see problems in Denmark at all. It's amazing. It's really amazing.
It is amazing. Now, you're self-employed, so this is your own business. But for people, so another question from the chat room. How much vacation time does the average worker in Denmark get each year?
It's an average of 5 to 6, perhaps 7 weeks.
I'm laughing because if you're lucky here in the United States, if you have a full-time job with benefits, you're lucky if you get 2 weeks paid vacation a year. And 5, 6, 7 weeks. Okay.
And when you are on a leave, you know, when I'm on my own and I have been self-employed for 20 years now, working as a coach. And when I was on maternity leave, then the government, they paid me for staying home, taking care of my children. for almost a year.
Whoa. You know, we have no paid maternity family leave. We have nothing like that over here. Nothing mandated by law. Amazing. My husband asked, what's the weather like?
Yeah, it's dark now, but it's actually, it's very beautiful weather at the moment. A bit cold, though. Uh-huh. But we have had very sunny days. But before that, it was raining all the time.
Yeah.
During nights, we have minus degrees.
Ooh. Yeah, I'm in Florida. That's the one thing we have going for us here. It's, you know, it's probably 80 degrees out and, you know, warm. But I would take the cold. You have heat inside, right? I mean, you can warm up. Marta Bolette, I'm so sorry that it took the coronavirus to bring us together, but it's so nice to meet you and talk to you. And, you know, as I'm calling today's show, it's a small coronavirus world. It really is a small world, and the fact that we're all in this together, I think it's a good opportunity for us to meet and talk. One more question from the chat room. Jeff asks, ask her about immigration. How is it over there? Say someone from America got so fed up with the fact that we have this crazy man running things, trying to become the next dictator of the world. Things are really, really getting, they're going from bad to worse over here. If someone wanted to come to Denmark and maybe set up life over there, how difficult is it?
I don't know the specific rules, but I don't think it's that difficult.
Really?
The important thing is that that you find a job.
Uh-huh.
And I have been helping immigrants. I coached a man from Iran who flew from the dictator for, I think it's 20 years ago or something. And then I coached him and he got a job, and he is a psychologist now in Denmark and having a Danish family.
Wow. Okay. Yeah. Sounds good to me. Not that I'm heading over there anytime soon. We can't get on an airplane. But it's so nice to know that there are civilized places in the world where humanity matters, where people are taken care of, where they're treated, you know, with respect. You know, here in the United States, there's this thing, there's this theory, American exceptionalism, and it's truly it's especially predominant among Republicans who somehow think they're better than everyone else. And there are people like me who know we are sorely lacking in the world. We don't treat each other well. We don't take care of each other. The fact that there's an industry around healthcare that makes a profit on the back of sick people is sick, actually. Yeah. There's something seriously wrong with that. It's nice to know that in other parts of the world, they don't deal with that kind of nonsense. Marta Bolette, it was so nice to speak with you. I thank you so much for joining us today and shining a light on civilization out there in the rest of the world. Stay safe. Thank you for sharing
you
some
so
time
much.
With us. It was so nice to meet you.
Yeah, all the best.
The same to you. Bye-bye. Take care. Bye-bye. What a treat. What a treat that was. Thank you so much.